और मुझे वाकई में आई वॉज अमेज्ड कि इस वीराने में आपने ये चमन बना दिया. इट एज ए सोशल एंटरप्रेनर वाकई में इट इज ए बिग एडवेंचर सर. एंड आई रियली कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू फॉर ऑल योर एफर्ट्स. बहुत अच्छा काम है जो जिस तरह से आपने क्या वॉइस आउट करवा दीजिए. मेरा सजेशन जो मेरे प्रेडिसेसर ने अभी कहा कि केबीके, आई हैपन टू बी द चेयरमैन ऑफ केबीके ओनली एंड आई थिंक कई चीज़ों का सॉल्यूशन केबीके यहाँ के लिए हो सकता है अगर केबीके सब ऑपरेशन के पास आ जाए. तो यू आर वेरी राइट सर. यू हैड सेड इट एवरी कि अगर केबीके आ गया तो इस एरिया का जीर्णोद्धार और काफ़ी हद तक हो जाएगा. दूसरा मेरा एक छोटा सजेशन और है कि आपके पास स्टूडेंट इतनी सारी वेल्थ है तो हर एक स्टूडेंट से अगर प्लांटेशन अगर एक ड्राइव करवाई जाए इनसे. और जैसे आपने कहा कि प्लांटेड बाई भी एक तख्ती लगी हुई है पीएससी कि डिफरेंट ऑफिसर्स आए होंगे, डिफरेंट सेल्वर्स आए होंगे. इसी तरह एक स्टूडेंट हर एक स्टूडेंट का अपना अपना अगर एक छोटा सा सैपलिंग अगर यहाँ पर प्लांट हो जाए तो शायद कुछ वर्षों में यहाँ पर एक ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन की फिर से होना जाकर हो सकता है. अच्छा, ये सब स्टूडेंट्स का ही था. इट वॉज नॉट देन बी आई पी. अच्छा, ग्रेट सर, ग्रेट. सजेशन वॉज वेरी नाइस. आई रियली कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू ऑल फॉर दैट. आई थिंक यू डिजर्व अ स्टैंडिंग ओवेशन. मैं अपने डेलीगेट से मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि इस पूरी टीम को पर्टिकुलरली हमारे स्टूडेंट्स जो यहाँ पर कोट धारण करके इस गर्मी में खड़े हुए थे हमारे लिए, इन सबको जो है एक मोमेंट एक अप्लॉज मिलना चाहिए. तो डिजर्व स्टैंडिंग.
Because we have demonstrated how we can, even in place like Bijapur, where there was no water. We have created and need oasis, and everybody, the land value has gone up quite tremendously there. Because, so that's why this cabin, this place is going to be a very important place. I would want to come and see next year, year after year, every year I would want to come and see. If you want me to come and teach, I don't give anybody because I am old enough. So I will become, I will be happy to come here, sir. And I, my students, you know, you do Sarantan is not. Keep up the Sarantan work, it is a very important work. You know, whereby every Saturday or Sunday you work and looking after the plants. And then papaya, when papaya comes, eat well. Papaya, mango, you know, you can eat well. I tell my students, Durgapur campus, whatever you get, you eat. Aisa karna chahiye, magar come, chalu rakho. Okay? Thank you, sir.
I'm Dr. K.S. Bangarwa, Emeritus Professor, Forestry, CCS, Haryana Agricultural University, Hisar. The National Agriculture Day Enclave organized by this university, I think that was successful. I would like to share my experience that in case of there is one popular tree that is exotic that was introduced from USA. That is the one of the best agroforestry tree. And for introduction and for the success of its plantation all over northern India, Wilco Seedling Limited is responsible. That has successfully introduced the tree and widely planted. They introduced the buyback guarantee. They introduced the buyback arrangement. And as a result of that, large number of farmers adopted. And I am sure this university will establish such examples. And one thing more, I would like to give one suggestion. Same with regard to the popular. I participated in one of the workshops at Dehradun. And organizers of the workshop, they arranged a field visit to see the plantation of poplar that was in Yamunanagar, eastern part of the Haryana. And this was the instance of around 2004. And in 2003, one training program was organized by World Agroforestry Center, Nairobi, Kenya. They also organized the field visit at the same place in the Yamunanagar. Yamunanagar is the best place for the plantation of poplar, and alternate field is planted with poplar. So here I want to point out that we cannot take our student to the Yamunanagar to show the plantation of poplar. We can have arrangement of videography and that can be shown to the students. Not only popular, similarly so many other practices which are not prevalent in your area, they can be recorded through video and can be shown to the students for the best exposure. And I hope this university will be able to do such innovative programs. Thank you.
Chancellor of the university, all the honorable delegates have come here for the national conclave. I am odd man out. My name is Dr. Pankaj Chande. I was the Vice Chancellor of Sanskrit University of Maharashtra and former President of Association of Indian Universities. Actually, because I had specially requested Shri Rai Sundiji that I wanted to see this university. So he yesterday phoned me and requested me to come all the way. He had made all the arrangements, so I am very much here. I would like to say I was really happy to see the total growth of the speedy growth of this university. I would not speak much about because I am not a student of agriculture, but I would like to point out one thing, that most of the agriculture universities in India are owned by other governments, different governments, central or the state one. There are very few, or other may not be, private agriculture universities. I don't know about it. But this university, though a multi-faculty university, will definitely grow. as a national agricultural university. I'm sure about it. Simply because the reason is that in rest of the universities, the vice chancellor is there for 5 years. He has the vision, he has the plan. He puts his he toys for the growth of the university. But the moment he changes after 5 years, or at the most second term or 10 years, the new man comes in with new different vision. So there is no sequence sometime in the growth of the university, because everybody has different ideas. The area changes. So, but here you have the person in the form of the Honorable Vice Chancellor, experienced Vice Chancellor. He was the ex-Vice Chancellor of Mumbai University. A grand experience he has, a national level experience, international level experience. And Sunil Rai Sunil, who is the Chancellor of this university, he personally comes here, visits everything, he studies everything. And I will tell you, the man started his career from a different area into education with a polytechnic. And today he has the biggest possible empire of higher education because of his experience and total guidance and cooperative nature, very cooperative nature. So I am sure that in days to come, since he is not taking any government grants for the growth of the university, there will be no less government interference, or rather no government interference, and he will have a free hand to put his vision in practice. And this university, I am sure, though a multi-faculty, as an agriculture university, as a university of animal husbandry, this will grow at a national level, and may I hope that it should grow at an international level. I will just quote one thing, that recently I am a member of CABE, Central Advisory Board of Education of India. So it is the highest higher education body of India. So while delivering introductory speech, the higher education chairman of Mr. Sharma told that only one faculty is there where there is no unemployment, that is agriculture and animal husbandry. There is no unemployment for the graduates. So this will be a very good sign that if this university comes up very fast, prospers, definitely the young lads in this country or in this beginning with the vicinity and subsequently in the country will have the biggest chance to get the employment, which is the prime objective of education today. Thank you very much.
First of all, I tender my heartiest congratulations to the Honorable Chancellor, Vice Chancellor of this university, as well as the faculty members, students, staff, ladies and gentlemen, for this wonderful university to render commendable services to science and community, mankind and humanity, the grassroots level society, and the predominant agriculture-based national economy at large, where new graduates of agriculture have to play a major supportive role in totality. And I think this university is sure to come up as per expectations of great men like Maharana Pratap, in his old times, Mahamana Pandit Madan Mohan Malviyaji and others, who conceived and perceived the religious values of agriculture, horticulture and dairy, to build up a hunger-free and nutrient-rich, prosperous and progressive India with the help of very, very important extensive service development system, either through KVK or through the establishment of grand agriculture graduates. And I wish you very best, the whole university, the staff and the students, and possibly this is the only way to launch the door of scholastic paradise to open up there, whereby our students, here admitted as new seedlings transplanted to the garden of agriculture, to blossom with the passage of time at the best program flower of the world, to spread their prudent aroma of excellence across all areas, and to explode like a volcano of excellence around the world. Wish you all the very best and thank you all.
Honorable Chancellor, Honorable Chancellor of Institute, Honorable Chancellors, Mother Language, Sentiments, Meeting, Founded. Let me outset from the moment, congratulations in talking about the dissertation group that this first time they achieved much height in this. Now, you see, the good 6 month is for the first students, our teachers know that when you go for a science selection, the first principle says that target is a family capital and followed by the adapted as a second. You see the land and salt and the target and the water supply. So quite unfavorable. Still, they have a dream. Dream is very sky high. And that they have ideas. And see the progress in the last 2.5 years is really unthinkable. Now, for any organization education institution to grow up, the 3 things are required. One, the competent teachers, two, the students, and third is your enabling environment. And when you say enabling environment, is the administration with the decentralized freedom of decision-making, infrastructure, and fund. This education group, headed by the Honorable Chancellor and Dr. Bhai Chancellor, has fulfilled all these dreams. The public university is led the third part. Though we get competent teachers, we get talented students in the private public university, then the private university. The third thing, where the funds crunch, freedom, decision, and infrastructure will lay. And this is the one with the model for others. I'm sure this private university, the Cambridge University, we establish its template for others, emulate, so that others universities will measure their standard with the scale established by this university. I'm sure the companies will have a very excellent trajectory for the universities. Thank you.
Honorable Chairman, Vice Chancellor of this university, only stalwarts, Vice Chancellors, delegates, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, I was former Director Extension of Rajasthan Agricultural University and presently headed the private university as the Dean Faculty of Agriculture. And I am working in private university from last 3 years. And so far I have seen so many of private and public sector universities in India and abroad. But I have not seen such type of a university which are taking care of about the research extension and teaching mandates of the ICR in a very sufficient manner. I personally discussed the students' modalities, what is the way of teaching of this university. All students are really happy and you have already implemented the 5th Dean Committee all the courses. I discussed with our students also. They are also happy. I also see different laboratories also there because I have experience of the private university working from last 3 years. There is a large distance between the chairman, vice chancellor and the student and faculty. But here I find that there is no difference between the vice chancellor and the students, even the registrar also. Even myself as a working as a dean, it is very difficult for me to contact my chancellor of the university. And if there is no interaction with the students and faculty, no problem will be solved. And I have not seen any university in the world, which is even in a private university that has so much of the infrastructure and congenial atmosphere in this university. I really congratulate to the chairman, vice chancellor and registrar also. Some of my senior delegates have already posed the establishment of Krishi Vigyan Kendras. Though this university has a sufficient land for establishment of Krishi Vigyan Kendra, that only leaves 20 acres of the land. Even in Rajasthan, I am founder director of Extension Education and established more than 42 Krishi Vigyan Kendras of NGO and ICR and SE also. They never are working very effectively. Though in this university is also taking care of the farmers training, farmer women training, all programs are taking care. But even establishment of KVK is mandatory because we all are MS, a very unique time period. The expectations from agriculture sectors are increasing day by day, but everybody of us are experiencing the crunches of resources. But I hope this university may come at the top, not only India, all over the world. This is my whole wishes. Thank you all for your wishes. And also thank you and congratulations for giving us so many of good hospitalities during our tenure for 2 days. I really congratulate the chairman, honorable vice chancellor and register also for taking care of. Thank you.
Respected Chancellor of the University, Vice Chancellor and our young and energetic registrar and Mrinalini Madam, all the faculty members, delegates and students.
actually I belong to Rajasthan from the arid area, and rainfall pattern is almost synonymous or parallel to the Rajasthan area. So in this scarcity of water and in a very small span of the time, wonderful development of the trees, intercropping system, our poultry set, cow set, even greenhouse, a wonderful development in a very small period of its life. Secondly, what I observed, I think you have selected young team of the agriculture teachers. So nowadays, industrial camp give a good growth of any of the unit. And as sir, Chancellor sir, I tell you, now a time of, earlier there was a boom of the engineering. And very good strength was getting entry in the engineering stream. But now there is a serious migration of this engineering bio students towards the agriculture. For your information, I tell you, in Rajasthan, in addition to 6 agriculture universities of the government, there are 26 universities. They are running agriculture faculty, and a very good number of students are getting admission in agriculture. So you have taken a very wise decision at right time, and around 10 to 15,000 of students will get degree of the agriculture in Rajasthan after 2-3 years. My little suggestion, keeping in view of the scarcity of the rainfall, although there is a scarcity of the water, but we are managing in a very nice manner, we can promote, I must have some collaboration to raise a short duration crops, so that whatever the scenario of the monsoon, we can get a better yield in failure of the monsoon. So I had been serving the agriculture project of the government university and serve various positions. So short duration crops can be developed or can be procured, and we can get good production, and seeds should be disseminated to the farmers. So it will be very big help to the farmers of this area if we can give them the short duration seeds of various kharif crops and in rabi crops. Secondly, we can develop seedlings of fruits and the vegetables, and that can be given to the farmers. Once I visited Parbhani Center of Maharashtra, and there was a Latur Center, and that center developed 10 lakh seedlings of the banana, and they were distributed to the farmers. And once minister visited, he outrightly announced the biotechnology center at that Latur Center. So supplying the good material to the farmers, it is a very big achievement of a agriculture unit. With this, I give stop my comments. Secondly, in the last, I would like to convey thanks to all your management committee and all the committees which hospitality which we observed. Actually, I have attended so many international conferences, but this conference is closing to the, my prior conferences. Once I visited Israel, so facilities we are getting advanced to the Israel also. So it is resembled to the international conclave. So I give my best wishes for better growth of this university. Thank you all.
Testament. Thank you very much for all your suggestions and inputs. We take it with an open mind and hope that when we invite you the next time, we would be in a position to bring that change that whatever you have told us. Now, with stalwart sitting in this room, it would not be fair if you don't solve the problem of our students. So I request the students, if they have any question in their mind, The whole plethora of galaxy of intellects are here. Students, please make the best use of their experiences and ask questions of whatever you want related to your academics or anything related to agriculture. Any students, please come over with your question related to academics or related to your field. And then after that, if there's anything, if we can take another, after that, few more feedbacks.
I am Anupam from JCA Agriculture first year. And my question is, my first question is, what kind of scholarships are we providing to the general categories? This is the burning problem of India. Because yesterday, the Rathore sir has only pointed out the scholarships about the STSC and minorities, and there was no point of general categories. Actually, I am not talking about the reservations, I am talking about the scholarships to the general categories. Because a lot of people, lot of students are belong to the general categories and they are very poor. And my second question is, what is the career in the agriculture other than the government jobs? Thank you.
Good afternoon, Moli. Young student has asked some questions. The main question related to scholarship to general category. Maybe at the entry level, there may be limitations of the scholarships. But while you are going on the higher side, there are a lot of opportunities of scholarships, either at the master's level or doctorate level. And ICR has launched an excellent scholarship, Netaji Subhash Chandra. And at the country level, there are so many opportunities of scholarships from here and there that you have to find out. But as far as the job opportunities are concerned, after doing BSc or MSc, particularly BSc, maybe in state of MP, since it is located in MP, and the students are coming from Maharashtra and MP, both the states. So in state government, maybe assistant agriculture officer, maybe agriculture supervisor, maybe assistant horticulture officer, even banks, lot of job opportunities are there in banks, seed companies, seed corporations, certification agencies, and also the fertilizer companies. There are a lot of fertilizer companies in the country located in various locations, and beyond this, the drip irrigation companies, and beyond this, the companies which are dealing in hybrid horticulture, either in monocropping cultivation. I can quote only one example, China versus India in field of monocropping cultivation. We started protected cultivation somewhere in 90s along with China, and you see what is the area in China as on today and what is the area in India. With great efforts of government of India, because of lot of subsidy is being given under the NHM, which is now being known as MIDS, and other schemes, NHB, other RKBY, the total area is 70,000 hectares, all together, public sector or private, individual, all together. And China is presently growing, using 35 lakh hectare area, 3.5 million hectare area under protected cultivation, and out of that, 95% is being used for vegetables and 2.5% for fruits and around 2.5% for the floriculture crops. And out of this 95% being used for vegetables, more than 50% is being used only on hybrid seed production. and I would say in production is a lot of scope. What I mean to say, they have developed, why we are not progressing? एक किसान ने ग्रीन हाउस बना लिया, रोड पे चले गए, उसको ये नहीं पता ग्रीन हाउस में क्या लगाना है, उसमें वेंटिलेशन का लेवल क्या होना चाहिए, यहाँ पे बैठे हैं, यहाँ पे क्या क्लाइमेट की कंडीशंस है, उसको नहीं मालूम है कौन सी वैरायटी टमाटर की, खीरे की, सीडलेस की लगानी है। लेकिन यहाँ पे कंपनी बनाया, ग्रीन हाउस चली गई, ड्रिप वाले ने ड्रिप लगाया, देयर आफ्टर नोबडी इज देयर हु कैन गाइड द फार्मर रियली, देयर आफ्टर देयर इज नो मेंटेनेंस, नो टेक्निकल नो हाउ इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड टू फार्मर्स। ये सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज है। और चाइना ने क्या किया है, चाइना ने किया कि एक सेगमेंट बहुत बड़ा बच्चों का डिप्लोमा कोर्स, आई जो हमारी आईटीआई है, ऐसा ही डिप्लोमा कोर्स उन्होंने किया इन ग्रीन हाउस डिजाइनिंग, फैब्रिकेशन एंड देयर आफ्टर मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर्स। ये सबसे बड़ा काम किया। दूसरा, जो आप जैसी यूनिवर्सिटी है, स्टेट एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटीज है, उनमें एक बहुत बड़ा ग्रुप बच्चों का तैयार किया कि क्या करो, व्हाट वैरायटी, हाउ टू रेज द नर्सरी, व्हाट इज ट्रेनिंग एंड पोलिंग पिंचिंग, व्हाट इज द वे ऑफ पोलिनेशन, हाउ टू हार्वेस्ट, हाउ टू एड वैल्यू एट फार्म लेवल। ये पूरा काम उनको सिखाया और आज एक इतना बड़ा बच्चों की फोर्स वहाँ तैयार हो गई जो स्किल्ड मैन पावर है। तो ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर जो बात कर रहे हैं ना स्किल्ड मैन पावर की, वो सबसे बड़ी कमजोरी है हिंदुस्तान में, सबसे बड़ी। और आज एक किसान हाइब्रिड बीज पैदा करता है, डॉक्टर साहब बैठे रानी बेंगलुरु में, एंड यस्टरडे आवर ऑनरेबल एक्स डायरेक्टर एंड एक्स वाइस चांसलर वाज मेंशनिंग अबाउट दी कि किसान का कितने बिकता है टमाटर का बीज, 10,000 रुपये किलो मिलता है रॉ सीड, और वही सीड जब पैक होकर बाहर से वापस हिंदुस्तान में आता है, वैरायटी का नाम लग जाता है, अच्छी अट्रैक्टिव पैकिंग हो जाती है, वो 1,00,000 रुपये किलो हो जाता है। तो हमारे यहाँ भी सीड इंडस्ट्री की, हाइब्रिड सीड प्रोडक्शन का, नर्सरी रेजिंग का बहुत बड़ा स्कोप है, और स्किल डेवलपमेंट की और जॉब्स की तो बेटा को अपॉर्चुनिटी की कोई सवाल ही नहीं है, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज। बस आपको ये बताना है कि आपकी स्किल्स क्या है, आपके अंदर कितनी वो है। अब मैं नेशनल एक्सपर्ट हूँ प्रोटेक्टिव कल्टिवेशन का, मेरे से रोजाना लोग पूछते हैं कितने लोग जो बिजनेसमैन आए हैं, अब मुझे 2 बच्चे दे दो, मुझे 4 बच्चे दे दो, मैं बच्चे कहाँ से दूँ, जब तक बच्चे जानेंगे ही नहीं तो बच्चे उनको देंगे कहाँ से, दे आर रेडी टू पे एनीथिंग। सो जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज की कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, हर सेक्टर में जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं, चाहे वो अब इंडस्ट्रीज, फूड इंडस्ट्रीज आ रही हैं, प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज आ रही हैं, फर्टिलाइजर इंडस्ट्री हो, प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टिवेशन की जो इंडस्ट्रीज हो, ड्रिप की कंपनी हो, सीड हो, देर आर लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन एग्रीकल्चर। लेकिन बात वही आती है जो मैं खड़ा होकर कहना चाहता था, लेकिन टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट था। मैं आई थिंक मैं बता दूं हमारे बच्चों की जानकारी के लिए कि शायद गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर में, पब्लिक सेक्टर में किसी स्टेट ने यंगेस्ट वाइस चांसलर मुझे लगाया हुआ एट दी एज ऑफ 51+। और मैंने मेरी बच्चों की वजह से वो बैठे हैं वाइस चांसलर साहब, वो तो बहुत मजबूत हैं, उनके पास तो इतनी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है, अब वो संभाल नहीं सकते उसको, लेकिन मेरे पास कुछ नहीं था। और इतने कंस्ट्रेंट्स होते हुए मैंने वहाँ जोधपुर की इतनी हार्श कंडीशन में उस यूनिवर्सिटी को 2 साल में बना दिया है। मेरे पास ताकत क्या थी, मेरे पास ताकत थी बच्चे 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 ताकत थी मेरे पास। और अब मैंने बच्चों की मदद सब काम किया है, अभी रिक्रूटमेंट किया है, बात वही आती है, मैंने यूनिवर्सिटीज में इंस्पेक्शन किया, डॉक्टर साहब ने भी किया, वो भी वाइस चांसलर उदयपुर में। लेकिन सबसे बड़ी एक ही रिक्वायरमेंट है कि जब तक हम हमारे बच्चों को क्वालिटी एजुकेशन नहीं देंगे, मैंने बहुत सारी प्राइवेट यूनिवर्सिटीज देखी हैं, बट रियली वी आर लक्की कि यहाँ के जो ऑनरेबल चांसलर हैं, जो चेयरमैन साहब हैं, वो जो बता रहे थे कल्ला साहब प्राइवेट में काम कर रहे, दिस इज रियली हैपनिंग कि चांसलर को, चेयरमैन को कोई नहीं देख पाएगा। एंड वी आर फॉर्चुनेट, यू आर फॉर्चुनेट कि कल से चांसलर लगातार हमारे बीच में बने हुए हैं। अब वो ऐसी हार्श कंडीशन में जहाँ का क्लाइमेट, जहाँ का पानी, जहाँ की जमीन इतनी इतनी दुखदाई है, फिर भी प्रयास कर रहे हैं, और इतने ग्रामीण इलाके में, इतने रिमोट एरिया में, तो निश्चित है कि ये इलाका आगे एग्रीकल्चर में डेवलप होगा और ये बहुत आगे जा सकता है। बस इसमें एक जरूरत है, क्वालिटी एजुकेशन से कंप्रोमाइज नहीं करना चाहिए हमें किसी लेवल पर भी। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
Now the lunch is already ready, and some of the vice chancellors and delegates, they have to reach to the airport. And therefore, before we conclude, I would like to request Chair Saab to say answer the question of the student, and then I'll take one more minute after that, and then we go for lunch.
I request all the students to please count it.
Students, if all your students keep membership to the group, then the credit will be provided. So, हमारा देश खुश कर रहा है, देश होकर भी फार्मर्स सुसाइड क्यों कर रहे हैं? उनके मतलब ये रोकने के लिए गवर्नमेंट क्या कर सकता है?
Actually, we have a lot of agriculture entities, research centers, and a lot of expert persons like all of you. But simply, हमारे देश agriculture के क्षेत्र में other countries से पीछे क्यों है? क्या आपको दिख रहा है? इनकम जो है वो कैसे बढ़
profit of margin has to be increased. Production, we are increasing, no doubt.
but margin of profit for the farmer that has to be increased. This is very important. So these two questions, certain one thing about one question about agriculture one has asked, that why agriculture is not, some student has asked about agriculture in our country. That is all right. Now this is very important. You can have a full seminar on this type of question which they have asked. So I think you will excuse me. I promise I'll come. I my own expenditure. You must not pay for it. And I will come to interact with these young men. Interact among our colleagues so many times in so many seminars, and same things are being repeated, 90% repeated. We look for, is there some new ideas? So we keep on looking for this. But many new things are coming. I request my senior colleague, Dr. Patil, he is very competent scientist, very competent guide, and he is guiding agriculture in different states. Please excuse me. My flight will not be delayed, I have to leave, but I promise I will come and I will interact with you for full day.
You all people arranged the conclave and opportunity now to interact with the student. That was one of the sessions. This is the last session, after that lunch is the session. So several questions which you have asked. So agriculture is the mother of all industry. You know it?
Yes.
Yeah, no problem. At the head of all sciences and arts stands neither the science of militarism which destroys, nor the art of commerce which accumulates, but stands agriculture, the maintainer of human life. So want a breakfast, dopahar ka lunch, snacks, night food, otherwise no sleep, no thinking, nothing. You have to go as hunters. So you have become civilized people with mobile, going in aeroplane. That is agriculture contribution. So this is the background. As regards your own prosperity and opportunity, most of the students prefer to become IAS from agriculture. It is good. If they go, the policies will be better. From IRI, when I was director, 28 students became IAS officers. I asked them, why you are going to IAS when genetics and planting, PhD, you have completed. Sir, we are practical, you are scientists, you are talking like a scientist. You will sit in the red light car at a big meeting just in a year. Becoming a scientist, it takes 20 years to achieve that. So we want to go, no problem. So there is avenue open, commercial tax. Even from Darwar, there are 500 breeders in different companies who are breeding vegetable varieties, fruit varieties, field crop varieties. In Hyderabad itself, there are 300 breeders from Darwar University. So this is seed, fertilizer, biofertilizer, pesticide, irrigation, drip irrigation, business, branding, in national and international markets. So all these are whether agriculture, the Raisuri University can take it to agribusiness or agriculture business course. So this is where there is large. So you divide yourself in your mind whether you want to become professional agriculture graduate or you want to become non-professional job. So if you are non-professional IAS, tax, etc., there are many post people managers, there are many controllers from agriculture graduate. What you choose at what time to give your own interaction with your family, how to earn immediately after graduation, that decides your career. So if you can wait and then really think for 6 months or 1 year after graduation or post graduation, definitely you will get your professional lot. Otherwise you choose whatever you want, but there is a lot of scope for agriculture. I will tell some examples as a professional people. Yesterday I told. There is one Abdul Rao who studied up to 9th class. I told yesterday also when I was there. They are not there. And he has 500 acres of land which he has earned after dropping from 9th class. and he is exporting by rail to different countries. And he sits in a tree, when he puts a button, his fathers are on, his grip is on, pesticides are sprayed automatically, there is no labor required. And he has 5,000 tea trees, the value of the tea tree is 50 lakhs, 550 crores. So that he has created. So that means if you work hard in the field also, there is a lot of scope. There is one lady yesterday I quoted from Raichur. She has 7 acres of land and she is growing mango, sapota, pomegranate. And then on that she is growing sandalwood. Sandalwood, she says after 12 years, she is going to be a crorepati. Now she is lakhier, she is going to be crorepati. So what idea, there is one Sare Patil's total income is 25 crores from polyhouses. And even here also you are trying to get polyhouses. Now what I request, Vice Chancellor and the faculty here, whether you can really erect an infrastructure which meets the demand of integrated farming system components, so that you can choose any component, whichever you, in a short time. So if you want to produce income 5 lakhs, you can go for sheep and goat. Within 6 months you can get, in the rear about 500 crores. Then vermi compost, these are quick. Then banana tissue culture, mushroom cultivation, apiculture. So many opportunities are there, but what is your determination of mind? How much time you are spending from morning to evening in gappa marne ke liye kitna hai, how much you sleep, and what are your activities, what is your planning every day that to achieve your career? These decide your career. Not the regular course, you may be a topper, but you may not get any job if you do not have a planning and approach. So planning, approach, and this is very important, how do you plan your career? So I think we are again coming to your university in June for planning process and all that. We will have greater interaction at that time. Don't worry, although you have come not by desire, I know you wanted to go to medical and selected engineering branches. By desire, you have not come. By default, you have come, but you have come to the right place. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor, and I must thank each and every one of you for giving your precious time. I am sure we will take your advice in future also, and then we will certainly take advantage of your wisdom which has been created in so many years. So thank you very much. I hope now this is the lunch time. So student friends, let them have the lunch. And we will invite each one of them in the coming years.